Hey guys, happy 1st of April and I'm back with another video. In this video I'm going to show you guys how I painted this llama for the Add Shirt Draw This In Your Style challenge. And because this is a challenge for AdShareLab, the company that actually makes a lot of art supplies, I will be working in my Etcher sketchbook, of course. Now, this video is already starting to sound a little bit like a promotion video. I'm just letting you guys know I'm not in any way sponsored. I'm a very, very small YouTube channel. I'm just a really big fan of the brand and I'll just be using it today. So just wanted to let you guys know. So for this Draw This In Your Style challenge, they posted a picture of a llama on their Instagram. And I felt a little bit art blocked, a little bit bored with what I was doing. So I thought it might just be a nice break for me to do something else today. And of course you guys know me, I like fluffy, cute animals, and I think a llama is no exception to that. And also, I don't really draw these kinds of animals often, so it was a fun thing to draw something else today. I also wanted to challenge myself and include the background. I think that's always when there's a Draw This In Your Style challenge and there is a background, it's kind of necessary to include it, to me at least, so I also wanted to include it here. And yeah, it was a real challenge to paint this background, but I think it turned out pretty okay and I'm quite happy with it, so yeah, it was a lot of fun. I used my colored ballpoint pens of Stabilo to actually draw the llama in this blue color and the background in this purple color, and I don't think I'm really satisfied with that. I'll probably do it in a different way next time, but it was fun to try out. And yeah, I learned something about what I like and what I don't like, so that's valuable. That's really valuable too. So a little bit more about the materials I'm using. I told you before that I'm using the AdShareLab sketchbook. I'm using the hot press edition and I really like this smooth paper. I'm also using my Sennelier watercolors as well as my Kaya natural watercolors. And this is not a well-known brand, but I'll be talking more about this watercolor set in a different video. I'm just going to say that they're really, really granulating and I'm using them in the last layer that I'm going to put on top of this layer. Since I feel like watercolor is my main medium, but I still want to get better in it, I want to experiment a bit more with different kinds of watercolors, where I think about which watercolors I use and why I do it and which kind of effects they can give me. So what I'm talking about in this video, I'm starting with a non-granulating paint first to get a flat wash first, and then on top of it where I want granulating colors to pop up, I'm using them more. And before I didn't really think about this, but I want to use that more in my work. I think that granulating colors can be so beautiful when used in, for example, fur or natural things like the background here. But it's not as good for artificial things like metals and such. And I'm just trying to think about that more. And I also want the granulating effect to pop more by not using it everywhere. So that's something else I'm thinking about. Now this video is very, very short, so I have to talk quickly if I want to say everything that I want to say. But I just, really, you guys, these are quite difficult times. I don't really want to talk about that, but I want to say that this is a great time to find yourself and a great time to have fun with your art. So I think that's something that I really want to give to you guys in this video, is find things that make you happy and yeah, just have some fun. Take some time for yourself. Relax, don't think about all the bad things that are happening and try to have fun. I've been sitting inside for quite some time now. I think my city got hit pretty hard by the virus. And in the beginning it was really, really frustrating because I just wanted to go out and sit in the library and work somewhere else. But now I want to take some more time for myself. We don't have a total lockdown, so I'm allowed to go outside and take some walks to clear my head. I've also been listening to audiobooks and I have been drawing a lot. And I've been allowing myself to just draw for fun. And yeah, I hope you guys can find something too for yourself that will make you feel happy and just to take your mind off the things. So for me, this llama was a nice distraction, and yeah, I think that playing with these colors was really, really relaxing for me, and I didn't really care how it turned out. Well, of course I wanted it to be pretty, but I didn't mind making mistakes at all, because I just wanted to, like I said, have fun. And if I'm learning something from it, that's even better, of course. For my next videos, I want to keep this positive energy to it, and I'll be posting from now on every Wednesday. So yeah, if you want to see more of me, I'll invite you to follow me on my journey. I'll put my Instagram in the description, and if you can, like and subscribe me. And I hope to see you in the next video.